This is what is kind of being called islands of interest. Declared at the top of the page. So the whole page. I'm not going to do any of that at the page level. I'm only going to do it at the component level. When I render a component, I'm going to say this component is going to render my service. I'm not sure how useful that is, I think. But in reality, if you've made the decision that you want, like server, into what the options are, but there may be more. So this happens to be Visual Studio 2022 preview. If we had more time, or if this was like a longer Blazor workshop, I might say let's do some stuff from the command line too, but it turns out there's just so much that I'm just gonna stay in Visual Studio. You can do all this with just dot, so to say if you like doing .NET new, which I actually like doing from time to time, you could say .NET new Blazor, which I believe is the name of the template in 8. I need a PowerShell. And then I need it to be bigger, and I need it to be on the correct screen. So, what is it? .NET new list, right? Or did they get rid of the list? Yeah, they did it. Look at that. Would get you the thank you. have to choose. These are all available at the command line with different dash dash options. By default, well, you know, let me be fair. Is this by default, or did they remember my settings from before? I'm not going to bet money on it. I can choose interactivity of none. Like, I don't need it at all. Or I can pick Blazor Server, or I can pick Blazor WebAssembly, or I can Blazor United Auto. I can pick that up front. I can pick, where is the interactivity? If I set this to none, then this option doesn't mean anything anymore. But if I set this to server, then what you'll see when you click global is one spot in the code where they wrap render mode interactive server, and you never have to worry about it from that point on. It's sitting in app.razor, and that's it. But if you say per page component, then they put that interactive mode on every page. And that's really nothing more than to show you what's possible. You aren't locked out of the other method. You could start this way and then be like, nah, forget it. Let me go put it in app.razor. Although what you'll probably do is say, I don't remember how to do that. Let me go make a new project real quick so I can see how to do it and copy it over. Or the other way around, where you say, you know what, I don't really want this to be global. Let me delete those lines, and then I'll put interactive mode at the top of my pages. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick global, and I will pick server. We'll do a couple of these. I'll try to keep them quick. I'm going to say authentication type none as well. And we'll watch these things open up because I want to